This is going to be the first of two videos about solving word problems with Venn diagrams. So here's the first problem. In a group of students, 15 are taking algebra, 11 are taking biology, 9 are taking both algebra and biology, and 3 are not taking either course. And then we've got three questions. How many students are taking only algebra? How many are taking only biology? And how many students are in the entire group? So one of the reasons word problems can be hard is because we get confused looking at the words and the numbers. They all tend to get jumbled together. So let's take down the important information, and at the same time, we can kind of review some of the notation and terminology that we use with sets. So we've got 15 students taking algebra. That means that we'll have a set of students that we could call A. Those would be the students taking algebra. And if I know the number of students in that set, I can write an N and then put the A in parentheses after it. And that will tell me that the number of students in set A is 15. I'll also make a set B for the students taking biology. And the number of students in set B is 11. I've also found out that there are some students taking both algebra and biology. So that would be the intersection of the algebra students and the biology students. And the number of students taking both algebra and biology is 9. And then there are students who are not in either algebra or biology. So if they were in algebra or biology, that would be a union. It would be the union of algebra and biology. But I know how many students are not in that union. So what I'm going to do is take the complement of the union, the complement of A union B, and the number of students there is 3. Okay, so now I've got all the basic information I need, and I can draw my Venn diagram. So I'll draw a rectangle for the universal set, and two circles in it, two overlapping circles, since I know that the two sets overlap. One circle for set A and one circle for set B. And now let's see what I know. I know that that overlapping area, the intersection of A and B, contains 9 students. I also know that there's a total of 15 students who are in set A, who are taking algebra. But 9 of those students are in the overlapping area. So if I want the part that's not in that area, I'll just subtract 9 from 15. 9 from 15 will give me 6. And now I've answered the first question. How many students are taking only algebra? Well, that'd be 6. So the second question, how many students are taking only biology, is going to have an answer we derive the same way. There are 9 students in the overlap, and there are a total of 11 students who are taking biology. So that means that there are 2 students who are taking biology who are not in that overlapped area. Okay, so 2 students are taking only biology. I also know there are 3 students who are not taking either algebra or biology. So that's going to be the students who are outside of those 2 circles, here somewhere else in the universal set. And then the last question was, how many students are in the entire group? Well, to find that, all I have to do is add together the contents, the number of elements in all of these subsets. So I've got 3 students who are not in either group, plus 6 more who are in only algebra, so that's 9. I've got 9 more who are in the overlapped area, so 9 plus 9 is 18. And then I've got 2 more than that who are taking only biology. So the total size of the universe, the universal set, would be 20. And I could write that, in fact, the number of elements in the universal set is 20. Okay, So I'm going to come back with another video, a slightly harder one. I just wanted to start with this to get a general idea of how to do it. So stick around. I'll be back soon.